Distributors fed at both ends at equal voltages with uniform loading. Okay, so let us recapitulate what we have learned in the last class, because this concept is related to what we have discussed in the last class. In the last class, we have discussed different types of feeder distributors. First, we have discussed distributor fed at one end with concentrated loading. Isn't it like this? Okay. So here the distributor is fed at one end, and the loading is concentrated loading. And then we have discussed distributor fed at one end with uniform loading. Okay. This is uniform loading. And then we discussed distributor fed at both ends with concentrated loading. Okay. Now today we'll discuss distributors fed at both end with uniform loading. Uniform loading means the loading are very close to each other. Okay, so it is uniformly distributed over the whole length of the conductor. So we have to apply the calculus concept. We have to differentiate and find out, or integrate. We have to integrate and find out. So what we have done in the last class for uniform loading distributor fed at one end. So see, if the total length of the line is L, and in uniform loading the loading is given in per unit length. So the loading we have considered I ampere per unit meter. Also the resistors we have considered R per unit meter. Okay, per meter or per unit length or per meter. Here it should be written ampere per meter, not per unit meter, per unit length or per meter. So what is the current entering in the feeder? It will be the total loading into the total distance, total loading per unit length into total distance, so IL. So what we have considered? We have considered a small length of the distributor at a distance X from the conductor, from the feeding end A. So what is the current at this point? Current is, see, the current entering is I into L, the total loading of the line. And some part of the current has been tapped from here. So the current entering at this point C is IL minus IX. Okay. So we have started from this point. The current entering at any point C at a distance X from the feeding end, it is IL minus IX. Okay. So we have started from here. So what is the voltage drop in a very small section of length dx? It is IL minus IX into R dx. R is the resistance per unit length. So voltage drop is IL minus IX into R dx. And it is the voltage drop over this small length. So what is the voltage drop from the feeding point up to this point C? We have to integrate from 0 to, okay. So this is the total voltage drop up to a distance, any distance X. And what is the total voltage drop throughout the length of the conductor? Definitely we'll put X equal to L. So total drop, it has been formed as half IR L square. Now this concept has been discussed today. This is for distributor fed at one end. Today we'll directly go to the distributor fed at both ends. Okay, and loading is same, uniform loading. I hope I'm audible properly. Okay, thank you. Now for this one, there can be we'll consider first the voltages at these two points to be same. Okay, both ends voltages are same. That is, if this is V, this is also V. Now, what is the, so it is symmetrical. Okay, if I is small, I is the loading per unit length. So what will be the total loading in the line? It is I into L. Okay, and as the voltages are same, you can easily conceptualize that equal currents will be fed from both the ends. Okay, because the loading is also uniform. So what is the current fed from each end? It will be IL by 2. So all the current, that is all the loading in this distributor, will be equally supplied by these two feeding points. So current entering here is IL by 2. Current entering here is IL by 2. Okay. Now, same concept. We have considered a distance x and we have considered small length dx. So what is the current entering at this point C? The current entering at this point C is the current entering here is IL by 2 and minus IX. Okay, same thing, just what you have used here, it is same. Only difference is that here only the current, total current was supplied from one end, and there that current is supplied from both ends. So here instead of IL, it will be IL by 2. So it is IL by 2 minus IX. So we'll start from here. Current entering at point C is IL by 2 minus IX. Okay. So what is the voltage drop over this small length? You can easily multiply by the resistance and integrate. If you want to find the voltage drop, simply multiply this current by the resistance. What is the resistance? R into dx. So what is the voltage drop over this small length? The voltage drop over this small length is dV, that is IL by 2 minus IX into RTX. Okay. Now, if you want to find the voltage drop from A to C, that means the drop at a distance X from one fitting point. So, you have to integrate from 0 to X, this one. Okay. So, same thing. So, if you integrate from 0 to X, you will get this formula, IR by 2 into LX minus X square, where X is any distance from this fitting point. Maybe you can also consider from this fitting point because it is completely symmetrical. Okay. So voltage drop in section AC is IR by 2 into LX minus X square. Now you can see from here that the maximum voltage drop will occur at the midpoint if we put X equal to L by 2. Okay. Also, you can easily see that here it is fed by V voltage, here it is V voltage, and everything is symmetrical. So, as you go from here to this side, voltage will decrease. Ultimately, at some point, it will be minimum. Again, it will increase, isn't it? Because it is fed at both ends with equal voltages. So, somewhere in the middle of the line, the voltage will be minimum. Okay. Exactly at the middle point because it is symmetrical. So exactly at the middle point, voltage will be minimum. So maximum voltage drop will occur at distance L by 2 from each end. So what is the maximum voltage drop? Maximum voltage drop you can find by putting X equal to L by 2. This is the maximum voltage drop. The value is IR by 8. Okay. So maximum voltage drop occurs at this point. Now, one concept is very essential. You have to use this concept in the next part. Because suppose this is L by 2. This point is L by 2 exactly at the midpoint. So what will happen? All the currents from this, say this is point P, from A to P will be in this direction, from left to right. And all the currents from B to P will be from right to left. Okay. So you have seen in concentrated loading in the last class. 1 minute, let me show. It is not here. In this class notes, you have seen here. Fed at both ends here. What you have found here, that when it is concentrated loading, the somewhere in between the line, the voltage is minimum. Okay, so from here, the voltage goes on decreasing because minimum at some point, again, it goes on increasing. But it is not at the middle because these distances are not same. Though they are shown equal, but they may not be equal. Okay, so it is not symmetrical. So what will happen? It will look somewhat like this, somewhere in between the fitting points, it will be maximum. Voltage drop will be maximum. And you have seen that when the voltage, we have solved many problems. We have seen that the voltage is minimum, say voltage is minimum at point D. If it is minimum at point D, then current in this distributor will reverse. That means on this side, the current will be in one direction. On this side, it will be in another direction. Okay. So the point of minimum potential is that point where the direction of currents are different in the two sides of that point. Okay. So here also we can find that if it occurs at the middle point of the line, the voltage is minimum. So current will be from this one to this one, and here the current will be from this direction to this direction. So it is, if you cut at this point, say this is point P, you divide it into two parts. Okay, say AP is one and BP is one. Then it will be exactly the same as a conductor fade at one end with length L by 2. Here also conductor fade at one end from point B with length L by 2. Okay, if you cut at this middle point. Again, we'll discuss this concept while discussing the next part. So up to this, I think clear the voltage drop, how it occurs, and what will it look like, the current loading and voltage drop diagram. See, the current is maximum, it is fed by IL by 2. So gradually the current is going out. So at middle point, it will become zero. Again, it will go on increasing on the right hand side, because minus IL by 2. Similarly, the voltage drop will be maximum at the middle. What is the equation? IR X square. Okay. So it will be IR X square by 2, I think. Maximum voltage drop. This is the expression for voltage drop in up to any distance x. So it will be parabolic. You can see x square term is there. So, and at the middle, it is maximum IR L square by 8. So it will follow this curve. This is the current loading and voltage drop diagram for distributor fade at both ends with uniform loading and with equal voltages at both ends. Otherwise, it will not occur at the middle point of the line. Okay. Now, just the expression of power. It is same, because expression of voltage, you write I into R. This is system, so you just write I into R. See, here you have written, this is actually I L by 2 minus X is I, and then R dx. So for finding out power, you just put I square R. See, they have put just I square R and integrate in the same way. This is I square. I into L by 2 minus X whole square. This is the current entering that point C into R dx. So power loss, you just integrate. And if you want to find out the power loss over the whole distributor, 0 to L, you have to write down. Okay. Power loss, it cannot be zero. It is not like the power, because power is square, I square. So it will not dependent on the direction of the current. It will dependent on the magnitude of the current. So you will get the power loss over the whole length of the distributor. Some students are very late in joining the classes. Anyway, so this is the expression of power. So up to this, is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Any questions from, thank you. Any questions from anyone? Okay, then I'll pass it. This will solve some problems. Okay. Then we'll solve one, only one problem is given. Then we'll go for distributors fade at both ends with uniform loading but with different voltages. You can understand if voltages are different, it is not necessary that the total loading will be supplied equally by the two end points, isn't it? It is not necessarily that this side is IL by 2, this side is also IL by 2. If this is IA, this is IB, then IA plus IB will be equal to small I into L. That's all. You cannot say that these IA and IB are equal. Okay, so we'll find what will happen. Before that, we'll just see how the problem. This problem is very simple. What happened? We have taken the distributor of length L 800, loading small I 0.4 ampere per meter, resistance small r 0.04 ohm per kilometer. It is given resistance of each conductor. So the resistance of both the conductors you have to write 2 into 0.04, and it is given in per kilometer. You can change it to per meter also. Calculate the maximum voltage drop if the feeder is distributor is fed at both ends with equal voltages. So maximum voltage drop, I told you that if the marks is 2 or 3, you can directly substitute maximum voltage drop. If you can remember, this is maximum voltage drop. Otherwise, you have to show the derivation, okay? Just it will be 2 or 3 lines derivation. In short, you can show. So it is just IR by 8. Just put the formula. What is I? Actually, how they have got IR by 8? Actually, this is IR L square by 8. By differentiating and put X equal to L by 2, you will get this one. And we have written it different way. IL into RL. You know IL is the total loading of the line. Okay. It is written as capital I as small r, small l. It gives a total loop resistance of the distributor, capital R. Loop resistance means the resistance of the whole length of the conductors, considering both the conductors. So 1/8 I into R or 1/8 I R L square, you can put and get this one. So what will be the minimum voltage in the distributor? Minimum voltage is 220 minus that voltage drop. Okay, and definitely it will occur in the middle because only uniform loading and equal voltages at both. Clear. So this problem is very easy. Now let us go to distributor fed at both ends with different voltages and with uniform loading. Now what we told that when the distributor is fed at both ends, where is the figure? Okay, now the figure is shown for this one. Anyway, we consider this figure. This is V and this is VV. Voltages are different. So the voltage is maximum here. It will go on increasing, but it will not go minimum at middle. It will go minimum at some point.
Ma'am, your voice is breaking.
Am I audible properly now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So you can find that the voltage is not necessarily minimum at the middle. You have to find out at what point the voltage is minimum. Now, for that, what they have considered, they have considered that at any point C, the potential is minimum and it is at a distance x from the feed point A. Say this is the feed point A. So there will be no current at point C, and current fed from feeding point A will be the current in section AC. What does it mean? Say this is point C. So it means that if C is the point of minimum potential, the current from this end will be exhausted at this point C. Okay, and current from this end will also be exhausted at point C, because in the last class you have seen this one. In concentrated loading, what happens? Current entering from this end and all the current from this end is going here. No current from this part is going to that side. Here also, current entering from here, all current is going this side. No current is going from this side to that side, because this is the point of minimum potential. Now, this is for concentrated loading. In distributed or uniform loading, what will happen? It is loaded at very small intervals. So we can say that at this point, almost no current is there. Okay, all the current has been exhausted just before this point, and in this section, all the currents has been exhausted just before this point. Understood? Why it is written here? Sorry. Why it is written here that no current from feeding point A will be, and the current fed from feeding point A will be the current in section AC. So if this is point C, all the currents entering from C, from A, will be exhausted at point C. That means at C, the current will be almost zero. And you can say that the current in this portion A to C, that will be the current fed by this feeder. And the current from B to C, that will be the current fed by this feeder B. Okay. Only this is the same concept. Okay. So the point of minimum potential will be that point at which the current at this side will be the current fed by this feeder, and current on the other side will be the current fed by this feeder. So if we want to find the voltage drop from, so it is just like the feeder distributed fed at one end. If this is point C, if the current becomes zero, what will happen? It is just like the distributed fed at one end, because here also you see the current is zero here. No current is going because there is no load connected. So all the current that is fed by this point is the current from A to B. Okay. So here also we can say that in this case, if C is the point of minimum potential, the current, say this is IA, IA will be equal to I into small x. Is it clear? This will happen only if C is the point of minimum potential. Again, I'm repeating. What we have considered? We have considered the point of minimum potential. We don't know the distance. Therefore, we have considered the distance to be x. So we have considered at any point C at a distance x, the potential is minimum. So what will happen? All the current in this part, in the loading on the left-hand side of C, will be supplied by this feeder. The current is IA. Say the current is IA. So what is the loading on this side of the feeder? It is equal to I into X. So the current IA is actually equal to I into X. So it is, what is this? This one is the, if we can consider this from A to C, it is a distributed fed at one end. And from B to C, it is distributor fed at and fed at again at one end. Again, let me show here because it is C is shown. Say this is the voltage is different. Say this is VA and this is VB. So if this is the point of minimum potential, then all the currents flowing from A to C is the current supplied by this one. All the currents flowing from B to C is the current supplied by this feeder IB. So we can say that this AC is a feeder fed just like it is similar to the feeder fed at one end A, and BC is also another feeder fed at one end B. Is the concept clear? Hello, anybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So we will apply the formula of the feeder, fader, distributor, fader at one end with distributed loading. Okay. So perhaps you have understood why it is the, it is just like feeder, fader at one end. Okay. AC, we are considering feeder, fader at one end. And BC, we are considering feeder, another feeder, fader at one end. Okay. Because the current C, this is the point of minimum potential. It will happen only at the point of minimum potential. So now what is the formula for the total voltage drop at any distance, say X? It is half IR, though they have written L square, L is the total length of the line. Okay. If the total length of the line is L, then voltage drop over the whole length is half IR L square. So here, what is the voltage drop here? Voltage drop is, 1 minute, here. So it is, it was half IR L square, but here what is the distance? We have not considered L.
we have considered x, isn't it? Instead of IR L square, instead of L, we'll write x because we have considered a distance x. So the voltage drop from one fitting point up to the point of minimum potential is IR x square by L. The formula they have derived, you can also derive from here. Okay, this is the for any distance x and the whole length, if we consider whole length, this is half IR L square. And in our case, what is L? L equal to x because we have considered the distance from the fitting point A, the distance is x. Okay, so this is the voltage drop in section AC, say from here to here. Now, what is the voltage? This is for the first distributor. We have broken it into two parts, A and C one, and B and C other. So, if this one is AC is x meter, what is BC? Total length is L, BC is L minus x. So, similar formula can be applied for this distributor because we are considering them to be two different distributors fed at one end. So, for AC, it is half IR x square. So, for BC, you can understand it will be half IR L minus x square because this length is L minus x. Okay. So, this is half IR L minus x square. Now, the voltage drops are C is the same point from here to here. Voltage drop if you get VAC, here to here if you get voltage drop VBC. Then what is VC? VC is VA minus voltage drop across this one. It is also equal to VB minus voltage drop across this one. Okay. So, potential at C will calculate from this voltage. Also, will calculate potential at C from this voltage. So, we can write that potential at C will be equal to VA minus voltage drop over AC. So it is given as VA minus IR x square by 2 because across AC voltage drop across AC is IR x square. Similarly, voltage drop BC is this one. So we can write VC is also equal to VB minus this one. So as VC is the same point, so we can write this one to be equal to this one. Okay. So as soon as you write this one and equal to this one, you have got one equation with one unknown x because all other voltages, currents, and resistances will be known to you. So from this equation, you can easily find out distance x. But what is that distance x? This distance x is the point of minimum potential. Okay. That you have to understand. X is not an arbitrary point. This condition will also happen, will only happen if the x is the point of minimum potential. Otherwise, you cannot consider them to be two different distributors. If C is not the point of minimum potential, what will happen? The current from this side will go to that side. Or maybe the current from this side will go to that side. The current will not end up here. So, you cannot consider distributor fed at one end. Only you can consider this whole system to be two independent distributors fed at one end if you consider C as the point of minimum potential. Okay, so the formula you have to derive, and you can also remember this formula. So have you understood how the formula has been derived?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so you cannot draw the diagram exactly because the current loading and voltage drop diagrams, because unless you know the values of VA, VB, I, it is not possible. But if you know the values, you can draw. Okay. Now let us solve some problems based on this. Now see, first problem. The problems actually are very easy problems, okay? So only you have to understand the basic concept that of the derivation, you have to understand thoroughly, okay? Then only you can attempt the problems. See, what is the problem given here? 800 meter L is given 800 and rate of loading, that means small I is given 1.2 ampere per meter. resistance is given 0.1 ohm per kilometer go and return. That means both conductors they have considered. Only thing is that you can, sorry. So 0.1 ohm per kilometer, you have to convert it in meter, and points are of the potentials at the two feeding points are different. See, one is 245, another is 240. So what you have to apply? You have to consider, they have written this one and they have converted into per meter resistance. So what is the difference of voltage VA minus VB? Because it is dependent on VA and VB. Okay. You can start from this equation, VA minus IR X square by 2 equal to VB minus IR L minus X square by 2. So VA is known, VA is 245, VB is 240. So I is given this one, L is given this one. So you can easily find out X from here. So they have just found out X here. And what is the question? Minimum voltage and its potential. So what is the minimum voltage? As soon as you know X, then the actually X you have considered from the feeding point A. That means to far from 245 volts. Okay. So it will be 245 minus IR X square by 2. Okay. Because what is the voltage drop? You know the voltage drop, you have considered it as a conductor fed at one end. So what is the voltage? Half IR X square. Okay. So here the voltage drop will be IR X square. So minimum voltage will be VA minus this one. Current supplied from feeding points A and B. So what is the current supplied? I told you that current supplied by this feeding point will be at, if this is the point of minimum potential at a distance x, then current supplied will be I into small x, small I into small x. The total loading will be supplied by this feeder, and total loading here, small I into L minus small x, will be supplied by this one. So IA will be L minus x. So IA will be capital IA will be small I into x. Okay, so it is small I into X. This is small I. X, they have found out this one. And fed by other fitting point is IL minus IL minus X. So this one. Okay. So this is very simple problems. We'll not discuss problems very thoroughly if they are similar. We'll discuss only the salient points. Let us see what the next question. DC distributor 800 meters long, fed at both ends. It is uniformly loaded at 1.1. Rate of 1.1 ampere per meter. Calculate the voltage at the feeding ends A and B. The minimum potential 230 volts occurs at C at a distance 500 meters from ND. So actually here, what is given? The voltage is not given. Okay. But what you have to find out, uniformly load, calculate the voltage. Voltages are different. You have to find the voltages at A and B. Point a minimum potential is given. Okay. So what is the voltage drop over this section? Again, you apply the same formula. Voltage drop over this section is half IR L square, only instead of L, you will put X. So voltage drop is half IR X square by 2. Now they have given the X. The distance of the minimum potential is given. It occurs at 500 meters from end A. So just put X equal to 500. So voltage drop you have got from this section for this section. And the voltage at this point is given. Voltage given 230. So you can easily understand. If you add the voltage drop with this voltage, you will get the voltage at point A. So voltage at feeding point A is this one. Okay. And what is the voltage drop in section BC? It is this one. IR into L minus X whole square by 2. So everything is known. So you can find out this voltage drop. And what will the voltage here? Again, it will be this drop plus this voltage. Because voltage will again go on increasing this side. Okay. So the two feeding endpoint voltages you have got. This is the same problem, only the known and unknown parameters are different. Okay. Now let us consider. 1 minute. I think I am audible properly.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you. Now, a uniformly loaded distributor fed at the center. Okay. Show that minimum voltage drop is IR by 8. See, this is actually similar to what you have discussed. Only it is shown is like it is drawn in a slightly different way. Though it is fed at center, what will happen? All the current from some current, if the total current is I, some current will go on this side, some current will go on this side. And as it is fed at the center and it is uniformly loaded, so you can easily understand whatever current is going to this side will be the current going to this side. So the if the total current is I by 2 will go to section CA and another I by 2 will go to section CB. Okay. So first part, let us first discuss the first part. Okay. Let the total length they have considered L. So this half length is L by 2, this half length is L by 2. Okay. So the maximum voltage drop will occur at the either end. It is obvious. It is fed at this point. So at point A and B, the drops will be maximum or the voltages will be minimum and their voltages will be same because this length same, loading same, and it is fed at the center. So maximum voltage drop will be voltage drop in half distributor. Okay. So it is also, see, what is the voltage drop in, it is also like fed at one end, isn't it? If you think of this CA and CB to be two different distributors fed at point C, so you can consider them to be independently two distributors fed at one end, isn't it? Because no current from this part is going to that side or this part is going to that side. So what will you can utilize the same concept. What is the voltage drop over the distributor? Half IR L square, isn't it? Where L was the total length of the distributor. Now here what is happening? Actually, this is one part, there is another part this side. Okay, nothing else. So instead of L, we have to write L by 2, nothing else. So formula is same, half IR instead of L square, we'll write L by 2. Okay, so instead of L square, if we write L by 2, then it becomes 1/8 IR L square. Okay, they have written it in a different way, or if you want to show it in this way, that it is half IL into RL, that means half of total loading into the total resistance of the whole feeder. Here the whole feeder means this whole. Okay, so you can write IL by 2 into RL by 2, so it gives 1/8 of IR. Okay. And what is the second part? The second part is simply the problem. L is given 900 fed at the center, uniformly at the rate of small I is given 1.2. Resistance of each conductor is given 0.04. So resistance of both conductors 0.08 ohm per meter. Find the maximum drop in the distributor. So maximum drop 1/8 into IR or 1/8 into IR L square. So just simply you put this one. Okay, just 1 minute. So here they have put the substituted the values. Okay, here maximum voltage drop is 1/8 into IR. So they have substituted the values and found out the maximum voltage drop. Okay, so you need to understand only this part. Okay, the first part, what happens when it is fed at one end? Why the formula for distributed fed at one end we are applying? Okay, now next one, this is a little bit complex thing. When till now we have considered either only concentrated loading or we have considered the only distributed loading, okay, or uniform loading. But what will happen if there is a mixture of two, both with concentrated loading and distributed loading? Okay, for that you have to consider different sections of the conductors independently, or you can use superposition theorem. You can consider first only concentrated loading, then you can consider only distributed loading, and then you can apply superposition theorem. So let us consider the first problem. In the first problem, see, the length is given 900 and the distances are given. If the distances and loadings are given, you should be able to draw it, okay? So the drawing is just like this, okay? So this is 50 ampere at a distance. This is a concentrated loading. 50 ampere at a distance 200 meter. This is this distance 300 meter. Loading is 100. Again after 300 meter, loading is 150. Again after one, no, this side is open. It is fed at one end only. And along with this concentrated loading, a uniform load is also there, uniformly loaded at the rate of 0.5 ampere per meter. So I is given, resistance of the conductor both way, go and return, is given this one for per meter. You have to calculate the voltages at point B and D. You may need to calculate all the voltages, okay? Now, this is one approach. In the next problem, I will show another approach. First approach is, what is this? Due to concentrated load, what will happen due to concentrated load? Just you have, in the last class we have discussed, due to, suppose uniform loading is not there. So what will be the current fed at end A? It will be just the summation of the load, 50 plus 100 plus 150. This load is flowing here. It is actually 300. What is the current in CD? 300 minus 50, that means 100 plus 150. So current here flowing is 250. What is the current here? This whole 150 ampere is flowing here. So you can easily find out the currents in the different sections, but here there will be no current due to concentrated loading as this is open end. Now, so you can easily find out the drops, AC, VAC, VCD, like that. What will be VAC? The current is, say, 300. So 300 into smaller into distance. So in this way, they have found out 300 into, this is smaller, this is distance. This is the drop in this section. Then in CD, this is the drop. Then in DE, this is the drop. Okay, there will be no drop due to concentrated loading here because no current is there. So what will be the total drop in AE or AB? The total drop over AB will be same as the drop across AE. So they have added these three and got the total drop up to point E or up to point B due to concentrated loading. Now they have applied uniform loading. What is the drop? Suppose concentrated loading is not there. What is the drop? The same formula, half IRL square. It fade at one end. You know the same formula is repeated over and over again, half IRL square. So the drop is this one. So this one, L is 900, so drop is this one. So what will be the drop over AD? Total drop is half IRL square. So drop over AD, the same formula again they have applied at any distance X, the drop is this one, IRLX minus X square by 2. So they have written the same formula, IRLX into X square minus by 2. So at a distance, say if you want to find at any distance, this is a formula, where by putting different values of x, you can find the voltage drops at different distances. If you want to find the drop at D, you need to put x equal to 500. Okay. So at different points, it is possible to find out. And after finding out, you can easily find out the voltage at point B. What is the voltage at this point B? This voltage is known to you, 410. So voltage at this point B will be voltage drops at different sections due to concentrated and distributed loading. Okay, so point voltage at B is VA minus voltage drop over AB due to concentrated and uniform loading. Okay, 410. So what is the voltage drop due to concentrated loading? Total drop is 18. They have written 18. And due to distributed loading, total drop is 20.25. This is this one. So this is the voltage at the farthest end B. So you can also find the voltage at point D by considering this distance. Put the distance of D here, see 16.25. They have used 6.25. And what they have used at point D for concentrated loading, you have to add this drop plus this drop. That means you have to add AC and CD, 6 plus 7.5. So they have added all the drops, 6 plus 7.5, and that of distributed loading to find out the voltage at the farthest end D. Okay. Now, is this approach clear? When both types of loads, that means concentrated load and uniform loading, is present. Is it clear?
Ma'am, bolchi you.
One by one, bolo.
Ma'am, bolchi uniform loading at time. But you can AD uta then mane AD ta jeta use kora holo ota mane half IR ma'am ekটু niche jan mane.
Eta bolcho? যদি মাঝখানে যে কোনো একটা পয়েন্ট ধরি তাহলে তো আমাকে এটা ইউজ করতে হবে, তাই তো? এখানেই তো এলটা বসিয়ে আমি এটা
পাচ্ছি,
তাই না? মাঝখানে যে কোনো পয়েন্টের জন্য তোমাকে এটা ইউজ করতে হবে ইউনিফর্ম লোডিং এর জন্য, ঠিক আছে? ধরে নিচ্ছে শুধু ইউনিফর্ম লোডিং, তবেই তো আমি এটা ইউজ করব। এখানে আমি তো আলাদা আলাদা করে ট্রিট করছি, প্রথমে কনসেন্ট্রেটেড করে দিলাম, তারপর ধরলাম কনসেন্ট্রেটেড নেই, শুধু ইউনিফর্ম করলাম, ধরলাম সরি কনসেন্ট্রেটেড করলাম, ধরলাম ইউনিফর্ম নেই, এখানে ইউনিফর্ম করলাম, ধরলাম কনসেন্ট্রেটেড নেই, তারপর দুটোকে অ্যাড করে দিচ্ছি, ঠিক আছে?
হ্যাঁ, ঠিক
আছে। আর অন্য কারোর কোনো কোশ্চেন আছে? ওকে, দেন উইল প্রসিড. So let us see the next approach, another approach, because next approach is very essential for you to understand. In some problems, you may find that you have to apply the next approach only. What is the next approach? Problem is same. I am not reading out the problem. I was just showing the figure. See, here it is 210. Here it is 205. Okay, in the earlier problem, this was only one end. Okay, you can apply. This was fed at one end, but here this is fed at both ends. Okay. Now, voltage here is 210, voltage here is 205. And the loadings are 50, 60, 40 at different distances are all given. And uniform loading is 0.15 ampere per meter. Okay. And resistance is given, you have to multiply by 2, this much ohms per meter. How to approach for this problem? You have to consider different sections. Okay. So if you consider different sections, say consider section AC, what will happen? The current, what is the current entering here? You don't know the current entering here. Let us consider current entering here is A and the current entering this one is B, IB. Okay, current entering at point A is IA, current entering here is IB. Of course, IA plus IB is equal to the total loading. What is the total loading? Concentrated loading is 50 plus 60 plus 40. And uniform loading is, total uniform loading is 0.15 into 300. So IA plus IB will be equal to 50 plus 60 plus 40 plus 0.15 into 300. This is one equation. We have to get another equation. Okay, from where you will get another equation? The two voltages are given. So 210 minus 205 will be equal to the voltage drops in these four sections. From there, you will get another equation. So let us see how to find the second equation. In section AC, what is the, we will consider the same way as we have solved this one. We will consider a distance x, okay, from here. Then if we want to consider distance x, what will be the current entering at this distance? It will be Ia minus Ix, okay. See, I have shown this approach. They have done it exactly in the same way what I will discuss, but they have not shown the procedure, okay. The first problem, I have shown the procedure. See, procedure is exactly same. In this portion, AC. Okay, we have considered a distance x from point A and length small dx. The same way we have shown here. So what we have considered? We have considered the current entering is IL minus Ix. IL minus Ix, current entering here. And if you multiply it by R dx, you will get the total voltage drop over this small length. So here also, I have shown like this one. Current entering is, instead of IL, I cannot write IL. I have to write IA. Current entering at point A is IA. So IA minus IX into R dx. And if we want to find the voltage drop over a whole section A to C, I have to integrate from 0 to 75. Isn't it? Now, is this clear to you? How I have written this one? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. So, nothing. We have not considered assume anything. Here, we have not made any assumption. Where is the point of minimum potential? How much current is entering? Nothing we have assumed. We have only assumed that IA is entering and at a distance x from IA, what is the current? Because here between A and C, there is no concentrated loading. Only uniform loading is there. So at a distance x, what is the current entering? It will be capital IA minus small I into x. And if we consider a small length here of dx, then capital IA minus small I into small x into R dx. That will be the voltage drop over small length in this section. And if we integrate from 0 to 75, it will be the voltage drop across this whole section A to C. Okay, so voltage drop over whole section A to C. Just these are just the simplification. Just to put the values, you will get this one in terms of course, IA, because IA is unknown. Okay, now for each section, the approach will be different. Then we are going to find out the current in this section CD. For that, again, we have to consider this length to be zero. When we are considering separate sections, we have to consider this distance to be zero. Okay, because that it is a dynamic condition. It is always changing. Okay, because both all the uniform and distributed and concentrated loading being present together. Now, let us consider a point X at any a point at a distance x from this point C. So we need to find out what is the current entering at this point C, because it is no longer IA. We cannot write that IA minus IX, because current entering at C is somewhat different. We have to find out that value. Then we can write it is, say, current entering at this point C is ICD. Okay, in this section, current entering from C is ICD. So it will be ICD minus IX. Understood? We have to find out what is the current entering here. Similarly, if we want to find out the voltage drop in this section DE, we need to find out what is the current entering this section from DE. Okay. So first, you need to find out what is the current entering at different sections. See, they have first found out what is the current entering. See, current just before load point, what is the current? Just before load point is not essential. We need to find out just current entering this CD. That means current just after the load point C. What is that current? Here, current entering was IA. Here, from A to C, how much current is going out? I into L. And after C, this is also going out. I into L means I into 75. And after this one, this is also going out 50. So, what is the current just after load point C? Just after load point C means current entering this section CD. So, what is that? IA into 0.15 into 75, because this uniform loading has gone out, minus 50. So, it is IA minus 0.15 into 75 minus 50. This is the current entering at this section. Now, is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, as soon as you find out current entering at this section, you apply the same formula. What is the voltage drop over small section? It is this ICD minus IX into RDX. So, ICD is actually this one, IA minus 61.25. So, voltage drop in next section is IA minus 61.25 minus IX. It is same. Here also we have used minus IX. But instead of IA, we have to write, actually we can, you can write IC or ICD. So, this is this one. Okay. And of course, the second length of CD is, I think, 100. Yes, length of CD is 100. So, integrate from 0 to 100, you find out what is the voltage drop in CD. Okay. Now, these things are, you can easily find out. And next section, again, DE, you need to find out what is the current after this point. So, the current IA minus due to uniform loading, you can directly multiply 0.15 by total length, 175. So, what is the current entering at this section D, DE? Current entering at section DE is IA minus 0.15 into 175. Yes, 0.15 into 175 minus 50 minus 60. Okay. So, it is, you will find it is coming to this value. Okay. So, two concentrated loads are going out. And the total uniform loading is 0.15 into 175. So, that you have to subtract from IA. So, the current entering this IDE is IA minus 136.25, IA minus 136.25 minus IX, and its length is 50. So, 0 to 50. So, you can find out. And last one. Also, again, you have to subtract minus 40, you have to subtract this uniform loading, and you have to find out this one. So, these four sections you have found out, this one, and this one. Okay. So, you have to add these voltage drops, and these voltage drops will be equal to 210 minus 205. Okay. You have to add these four and equate it to 210 minus 205, and you will get the value of IA. Is it clear how to, what is the approach for these types of problems? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. You need to solve by your own, only then you will be able to understand. Okay. And as soon as you got IB is very easy, because I have IA plus IB, you will get total loading is actually IA plus IB. And what is the point of minimum potential? That point of minimum potential you need to find out where the direction of the current will change, because it is a feeder, a distributed feeder both ends. So current is 150.55. So you can either by visualization, you can find out 150.55. Let us consider 150. So, what is the loading here? Current after point C, 150. So, it is positive. So, it is going like this. After point D, it is also going like this. So, after point D, it is also like this. Then after point E, I think E is the point of minimum potential. Why? Because you can find out directly. Say either from these values or by visualization. What is this one? This one is loading going out 75 into 0.15. So it is 11.5 and 50. It is 61.5. So current entering this section is IA minus 61.5. And what is IA? It is, we have got IA to be, IA to be 150, approximately 150.55. So 150, this one is 150, this is positive. So at C, the current direction is positive. That means C is not the point of minimum potential. Then after D also, I is 150.55, D also is positive. That means it is again going in this direction. But at E, what you find? At E, the current IA minus after point E, it is minus 183. Here, it is getting negative. That means in section DE, it is section EB, current entering after point E. Current after point, load point E means section EB. So in section EB, you are finding out that current direction is negative. Therefore, E is the point of minimum potential. In this section, it was positive. In this section, it is negative. That means at point E, the current is fed by both the sections. So E is the point of minimum potential. Okay. You have to find out the point of minimum potential like this. And the easiest way to find out the potential at this point is 205 minus this drop. Directly you can find out, or you can use from this side also, you can find it out. Okay, because you know the drops in all the sections. So after you find out IA, it is very easy. Now next problem, I think it is exactly same. Let's see. Then we'll not discuss if it is exactly same. Length is 400. Small I is 1 meter, uniform loading. Concentrated loads are given. It is on the basis of this data, you have to draw this figure. Cable has a resistance of 0.3 ohm per kilometer go and return. You convert it into meter. Determine the position of the lowest run lamp. That means you have to find out the point of minimum potential and its voltage. Just 1 minute. So, what you have to do, here they have given the cable is fed at 240 volts from both the ends. Okay, so you have to equate it with zero, isn't it? You find the voltage drops in all the sections individually, just what you have done in the previous section. You have found out the voltage drops in different sections, isn't it? You have found out the voltage drops in different sections. So you find out the voltage drop in this way and add them and equate to zero, isn't it? But in the previous one, you have equated it to 5. This is 5 because the voltages are different. But here you have to equate it with 0 because voltages are same, isn't it? I think there is no other concept is required here. It is exactly same as the previous one. You try to solve this one exactly in the same way. Everything is same. Here they have found out the point of minimum potential to be E. In the same way, where the current direction is changing, you consider that the point of minimum potential. So I think this problem is similar to the previous one. You can solve it by your own. Isn't it, any bias?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Now let us see the next problem is a different problem. A double circuit, three-phase, three-wire. Don't get confused with double circuit, triple circuit, etc. You solve it considering a single circuit. Okay. Then after solution at the last stage, you multiply by 2. Or if it is triple circuit, you multiply by 3. What? Which one to be multiplied? Let's see here. A double circuit, three-phase, three-wire line is converted into triple circuit, two-pole, two-wire DC line with same maximum voltage to earth as that of the AC line. okay, this topic, this is the problem combining the last what we have already covered, the topic with this topic. Okay, with the same maximum voltage as that of the AC line. So in the DC, if the voltage is V, if we consider the maximum voltage to be V, in AC we have to consider V by root 2. Okay, and it is given the line voltage, then we have to use the formula root 3 VI, not root 3, root 3. If it is line voltage, then root 3 VI cos theta. Of course, V is the RMS, so you have to divide it by root 2. So what is given here? See, first DC, for DC line, they have considered the DC line first. It is a triple circuit, two pole, two wire DC line with same maximum voltage. Now, voltage they have considered V. You can write it Vm also. Okay, better if you write Vm, then you will not be confused. It is not the RMS voltage in AC. Though DC doesn't matter, in AC it matters. So, what is I? I is V by V. And what is loss? Loss, you have to consider both the wires. So, this is the loss. Okay. For AC line, what you have to use? For AC, this is the maximum voltage. I told you it is given. Maximum voltages are same. You have to see what, you have to carefully note what is given with same maximum voltage to earth. So you have to consider that maximum voltage in AC also. So RMS value you have to divide by root 2. And as it is a line voltage, you have to use 3. 3 phase, not line voltage. I think this is a phase voltage. 1 minute, let me see. Maximum voltage to earth. Voltage to earth is the phase voltage. So you have to use the formula 3 V phase, I phase, cos theta. So this is the formula you have to use. Okay, then other things are same. What is I2? I2 is this one. What is loss? Loss is this one. Now, for as it is double circuit line, loss for single circuit is this one. For double circuit, you have to multiply by 2. Again, for DC also, DC is a triple circuit. It is given triple circuit, isn't it? AC is double circuit, DC is triple circuit. For triple circuit, for losses, you have to multiply it by 2. Okay, multiply it by 3. Sorry, triple circuit. This is triple circuit, so you are multiplying it by 3 at the last stage. And here you are multiplying by 2 at the last stage. Okay, this is the only difference. Okay, if they were all single circuit, you need not multiply it by 3 or multiply by 2. You have to carefully note that. Now, the transmission losses are same. This must be given, otherwise you cannot consider. So, see, transmission losses are same. So, if the transmission losses are same, you can equate those transmission losses, this one to be equal to this one. And you have to find out the ratio of the power transmitted in both the cases. So percentage increase in the capacity of three-phase double circuit line is 112.3%. Okay, so P2 is greater than P1. Okay, so three-phase double circuit line. Okay, the three-phase AC line, the percentage increase in power is more because P2 is the second system, that is the AC system. Okay, so first part is over. These types of problems we have solved in earlier classes. If you have read, you will be able to understand. Now, what is the second part? Second part is also actually based on this concept. This is written a two-wire DC distributor. Okay, 500 length is given, 500. Paired at both ends with equal potential. On both sides, the potentials are 250 volts. And uniformly loaded. It is uniformly loaded. Okay. Oh, also the concentrated loads are given. Calculate the distance A where the potential of the line will be minimum. That means you have to consider the point of minimum potential. See, up to this one, this problem is exactly same as that of the previous problems. What are given? This problem, this data, all are given, so you can draw this figure. And you have to find out the point of minimum potential. What are the extra data given? extra data given is resistivity is given this one. Calculate the minimum cross section of the conductor so that maximum drop may not exceed 20. Here there is some difference. They have given the resistivity but not the resistance. So you know R equal to capital R equal to rho L by A. A is not given. Okay, rho is given. L, okay. If you consider small r is actually ohms per unit length. So you omit L. So small r is equal to L by A. You consider only that. Small r equal to L by A. But again, this is unknown because A is unknown. But what is the data given? The maximum drop is 20 volts. Okay. Let us see how they have solved the problem. See here. Okay, this part you can solve it just like the previous one. In terms of R. R is now not known to you. So R is rho by A. Isn't it? So R will be the unknown. Okay. But if R is the unknown, total drop is this one. If total drop is this one, drop up to point E is this one. This up to this one, you can easily find out in terms of R. And you can equate this one with this one. Okay. Because the earlier part of the problem is exactly same. You use the same concept. You find the total drop in different sections, both due to concentrated and distributed loading. Okay, and it will come to this one, the total drop, it will come to this value 102500, but in terms of small r. And that total drop will be equal to 250, that total drop, they have equated it to zero. From there, you can find out IA. Now see, here R will get cancelled as this side is zero, isn't it? So there's no matter what is the value of R, as 250 minus 250 is there, so R will cancel out. This R will, you need not know the value of R to find out IA. Okay, now once you find out IA, then you can easily find out what is the point of minimum potential. Okay, just by observing. So from point of minimum potential is E. So now you find what is the voltage drop up to point E in terms of R. You find from this side or you find from this side, all the same, because both are 250. From any one side, you find out what is the voltage drop over the whole section and equate it to 20, because they have asked that voltage drop is 20. Okay, they have said the total voltage drop is 20. So you have to equate it to 20 and ultimately you will find out the value of small r. Okay, now as soon as you get the value of small r equal to rho by A, so you can easily find out the value of A. Only thing is that you need to carefully observe the units. Rho is given in what form rho is given? Rho is given in ohm meter. That means whatever A you will get it in meter. Okay. So that should be kept in mind. Now, is this problem okay? Hello?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then next there is one question. This question I've already discussed. Explain why the voltage drop is a primary concern in the design of distributors. Voltage drop is always primary concern in design of distributors, because you know that in singly fed distributor, the voltage at the farthest end will be minimum. So consumers at the farthest end will get very low voltage, but it should be above the minimum level. That should be always be kept in mind. So it should not exceed 6%. It should not be, the voltage drop should not be more than 6%. Okay. So this is very important. Even in distributors fed at both ends. Also in distributors fed at both ends, somewhere at the middle, the voltage drop will be minimum. Also, we have to, while designing a distributor, it should be observed that voltage drop does not fall below the permissible limit. So the voltage drop is of primary concern in the design of distributors. That is written here, though it is written 5% here. Okay, 5%. So it will be exactly, it should not be below 6%. Okay. Now we'll solve two more problems. Here it is different. I'll just give the hints. See how it is looking like up to from A to E. Actually, there is no distributed loading, only concentrated loading. This point and this point. Okay. And distributed loading is on the other end from here to here. Up to 200 meter distributed loading of 1 ampere per meter uniform loading. Okay. Now, two problems are there. They have used two different approaches. Now, see. In this problem, they have considered XD to be the point of minimum potential. It may not happen that D is the point of minimum potential. Now, if D is the point of minimum potential, they have considered current entering, current in this section, CD will be X. As there is no uniform loading here, so the current is same, okay, in this section, CD. They have considered current entering here is X. So what will be the current entering in this portion from this side? Total current is 60. So this side from this side must be 60 minus X will be entering. Okay. So if D is the point of minimum potential and we consider X to be entering here, so from the other side, 60 minus X must be entering from ED. Okay. So that together they will, it will make 60. This much assumption only we have considered. Okay. Now, assuming this one, we'll find out the value for X. Now, see, what is the voltage? What if this is X? What is the current entering at A? It must be 100 plus X, because 100 is going out, then X is going in this direction. So, current in this section IA is actually 100 plus X. Clear? So what is the voltage drop over this section AD? It is voltage drop across this section. That means ISC into RSC plus ICD into RCD. So what is ISC? ISC is 100 plus X. So 100 plus X into RSC. What is RSC? RSC small r is given 0.001. So 0.001 into what is this is 100. Though they have considered R, okay, they have considered in this way only, 100 into R. Okay, and what is the drop here? X into 150 into R, this one. Okay, so voltage drop, they have calculated in terms of X. R is known to you, you can easily substitute. Now, what is the voltage drop in BD? What is the voltage drop in BD from B to E? That is concentrated uniform loading. So you have to apply the same formula. Voltage drop is half IR L square. What is L here? L here is 200. So apply the same formula. Just 1 minute. So voltage drop is this one. And what is the voltage drop in this section? Half IR L square, L is 200. So it is half IR L square. What is the voltage drop in section ED? Here there is no loading. So it is simply this current 60 minus X into R into 50. Okay, distance is 50. So resistance is R into 50. Current is 60 minus X. So 60 minus X into, oh sorry, this is concerned, this loading actually 60 minus X, they have applied superposition theorem. It is entering from B, isn't it? It is not like that it is flowing through this section only. This current is entering from this one only. whenever you are getting uniform and concentrated loading, you have to apply either superposition theorem or you have to integrate it. So here they have applied superposition theorem. First, they have considered due to uniform loading, what is the voltage drop from here to here? The uniform loading is not in this section ED. So you need not use uniform loading drop due to uniform loading in this section. Then what is the voltage drop due to this 60 minus X? 60 minus X is actually entering from this point B. So you have to consider the whole length 250. Okay. So this is the drop over the whole length BD. And as the potentials are same, 250 and 250. So this drop AD will be equal to this drop BD. Okay. So you equate this one with this one. And what is the unknown? Unknown is X. Now X, they have got positive. Positive means X is flowing in this direction and the current 60 minus X is flowing in the opposite direction. So D is the point of minimum potential. Okay. You solve the same problem. It is your homework. Solve the same problem considering C as the point of minimum potential and see what happens. Okay. Consider C as the point of minimum potential. Consider X in this direction. Consider 100 minus X in this direction. Okay. And see what you get. Okay. So I think you will get the value of X, you will get more than 100 ampere. Okay. Then only you can understand that this is not the point of minimum potential. This is the point of minimum potential. Okay. So this is how we have got this, the value for X. And as soon as we have got the value for X, what they have asked to find out? Point of minimum voltage. This is the point of minimum voltage and the value for minimum voltage. So this drop you have calculated, drop AD, just from 250, you subtract this one, you will get the point of the value for minimum voltage. So value for minimum voltage, that's just they have subtracted from A and they have got. You can also check, you can subtract this drop from B, you can subtract this drop and check whether you are getting the same voltage. Okay. Up to this, is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Now, last problem. Here, though it looks like same, the approach is slightly different. You can use this approach also. See, here what is given? Let's directly go to the figure. Everything is depicted in the figure. The distributed loading is from B to D. Its distance is, why it is written 25 only? Okay, maybe some extra information is there. Let's go to the figure. 1,000 meter long. Distributor fed at both ends. One is end is 240, another is end is 242. Concentrated loading of 200 ampere at a distance of 400 meters. Okay. Uniformly distributed load 1 ampere per meter between the midpoint and end B. Between the midpoint and end B. Okay, midpoint is 500. From here to here, 500. Midpoint and end B. This is 500 and this is 500. Yes. Midpoint and end B is this other side. Assuming the cable resistance as 0.005 path 100 meter. So actually divide it by, for each code, you have to multiply it by first 2. So 0.01 and divide it by 100 to get ohms per meter. Determine the currents fed at A and B. I don't know. This information is not given. They have found out this one from the result. Okay. So forget about this 25. So all other information are shown here. So how to approach? First, voltage drop over BD. Over BD is 500. Okay. Here that is from BD, you have to apply the same formula. Okay. The formula is same and the distance is 500. So IB minus IX, there is no concentrated loading in between. In between this B and D, there is no concentrated loading. So you need not consider different sections. You have to consider different sections whenever there is change of current. Okay, but here only concentrated loading. So current entering here is IB. So IB minus IX into RDX. And you have to integrate from 0 to 500 to get the voltage drop from B to D. So voltage drop is this one. IB minus IX 0 to 500. So you will get this one. Now, what is the voltage drop in BDC? We are calculating voltage drop from this direction. You can also calculate from this direction. What is voltage drop in BDC? Actually, voltage drop in BDC, you have to find out the current. Okay. And at this portion, there is no loading. Only concentrated load is here. So what is the voltage drop in BDC? Voltage drop is BDC is IB minus Y, IB minus 500, the current flowing. What is the current flowing here? Current entering here is IB. What is the current going out? It is 1 into 500. So 500 ampere going out. So current entering this section is DC is IB minus 500 into R into this distance. This distance is 100. Okay. So it is simple. IB minus 500 into R into 100. Okay. Again, in the next portion, what is the current entering here in terms of IB? IB minus 500 minus 200 is entering here. Well, it is actually, it won't be entering. It will be the other direction. But we have to consider from any one end. So from this end, it is IB minus 200 minus 500. That is IB minus 700 is entering here into R into 400. So this is this one. So what is the total drop? This one plus this one plus this one is actually VB minus VA. It is not VA minus VB because this is at higher potential. Otherwise, you can also consider from this point 240 minus 242 and you will get the positive value for this X. Okay. So just VB minus VA, that means 2, equate this one. And you will find what is the unknown here. Unknown here is only IB. So you can easily find out the value for IB. It is 475. Now, if 475 is the value for IB, current entering here is 475. Now, up to this one, current going out is 500. So you can understand if the current entering through IB is 475. So no current from this section will go beyond D. It will be exhausted before D. See, up to this distance 400, up to this distance 500, 1 minute. What is the current value? 475. So all the current entering from B will be exhausted at a distance 475 meter because current loading is after every 1 meter, the current going out is 1 ampere. So 475 ampere, what is entering here will be exhausted at a distance of 475 meter. So at a distance of 475 meter from B, it will be the point of minimum potential because all the current entering from this direction will go out. And the remaining current in CD will actually flow from this other direction. Okay, understood how we calculated the point of minimum potential? As soon as we found it is 475, so better you find out IB also. What is IB? IB is, IB you have to again calculate. What is actually IA plus IB will be, they have got IB equal to, IB is not given. Actually, IB you can also find out. Anyway, IB will be equal to this one plus this 200 plus 500 into 1. This is the total current, IB. So anyway, as the total current entering here is 475, so you can understand the point of minimum potential will be at a distance 475 meter from B, because the current is 1 ampere. So all the current entering from here will get exhausted at a distance 475 from this point B. So E is the point of minimum potential, which is at a distance 475 from this B, or it is at a distance 25 meter from D. Now, is it clear how to identify the point of minimum potential?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. Now, point of minimum potential I've got, and value for minimum potential you can easily find out. They have found out the value for minimum potential from this formula. Voltage or drop up to this C. The same formula, instead of taking up to D, you will take up to E. The voltage drop, instead of taking up to this point D, will take up to point E. So only instead of 500 integrating from 0 to 500, will integrate from 0 to what? 0 to 475, isn't it? So they have integrated from 0 to 475 and found out the voltage drop. If they have got, as soon as you get the voltage drop, you can subtract that value from B and find out the exact voltage. Okay. In this way, they have found out. Now, is it clear up to this, all of you? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Hello, aaj ke class ta ekhane shesh kori. Class notes to acha. Tumra ekta kotha bolo to. Do you get the recording of all the lectures properly?
Yes, ma'am. Mail.
আচ্ছা তো মানে অনেকে আমার কাছে মেল পাঠায়, আমি তাহলে তোমাদের শেয়ারের রেসপন্সিবিলিটিটা একটু শেয়ার করে দেওয়া আর কেউ যদি কখনো ধরো কেউ পেলে না সেই ক্ষেত্রে শেয়ার আমাকে আমার কাছ থেকে নিয়ে নেবে ঠিক আছে সো अगेन উইল মিট নেক্সট টিউজডে ক্লিয়ার সেম টাইম
ওকে ম্যাম
ওকে থ্যাংক ইউ
থ্যাংক ইউ
এনি কোশ্চেন ওকে Thank you.